Onc Live Insights is a video editorial program produced by Onc Live.
The optimal role for stem cell transplant in follicular lymphoma is a very complicated issue. We typically don't recommend it as part of initial therapy. The risk-benefit ratio just isn't appropriate because our frontline treatments are so effective. But when patients get into the relapse setting, it is a treatment option that should be considered for younger patients. Patients over the age of 70 probably should not be further considered for stem cell transplantation, by and large. Some centers will do transplant over the age of 70, but most tend to draw a line there. Now, there are two types of stem cell transplants. There's autologous, where the patient uses their own stem cells, and allogeneic, where the stem cell source is a donor. Very different strategies. An autologous stem cell transplant is really relying on high-dose chemotherapy. I think that strategy is best utilized for patients with recurrent follicular lymphoma in their second or third remission. That is the optimal window to employ autologous stem cell transplant. And there are patients who can enjoy very, very durable remissions after that procedure. And I recommend it to my younger patients who have relapsed after R-CHOP or R-bendamustine and say they're 52 years old. And you're trying to figure out a strategy that will allow this patient to live 25 more years, and you have to think about all the treatment options you have. A stem cell transplant is a difficult procedure to go through, and patients only get older with time. So a stem cell transplant is going to be easier to get through at age 52 than it is going to be at age 58. So I will often use it earlier in the treatment course for younger patients. Allogeneic stem cell transplant is a completely different strategy. You're relying on a new immune system, and this is a strategy that has the potential to cure patients with follicular lymphoma, unlike drug therapy by and large. The problem is the upfront risk. Most of the studies show about a 20% treatment-related mortality in the first 2 years. So 2 out of every 10 patients you send for an allo transplant will die of a treatment-related complication in the first 2 years. And so that's a hard thing for me and a lot of physicians to subject patients to that upfront risk. So I normally don't recommend it until I see the patient is deriving suboptimal benefit from our standard treatments, and I'm starting to lose my faith that regular old treatments are going to establish quality remissions for these patients. And then the equation changes, and then I think the risk of an allo transplant is now acceptable because your standard options are now not meeting your goals. The optimal duration of maintenance therapy in follicular lymphoma is generally considered to be 2 years. Most of the studies that have established maintenance as an attractive treatment strategy have used a 2-year strategy. The rituximab can be administered as a single dose every 2 months, a single dose every 3 months, or 4 weekly doses every 6 months. But the total duration is 2 years. There are some studies that are looking at longer durations. There are some studies that are comparing 2 years to 5 years. The data so far suggests that there is a small incremental benefit for the longer duration, but it isn't much and probably isn't worth the 3 extra years of treatment for such a small benefit. And we actually did studies at the University of Wisconsin in mantle cell lymphoma where we tried to give the maintenance for 5 years. I felt like the trade-off wasn't worth it. Patients were on therapy a long time. We started to see problems with infections that I thought was more than we saw with 2 years of maintenance. And then obviously there's an economic issue, and I think we need to be very thoughtful as physicians about whether this additional therapy can really be justified from a cost perspective. Obviously, if the patients derive a big clinical benefit, then it's worth it. But if the benefit is marginal, then I think we should really think very carefully about that.